Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here again. Today is August 7th, 2013. Now, my friends, those of you been watching me, right? You know that today I had a court date and a summary judgment motion to evict me from my home. The Banks and the Weasels, they took me to court today. And people, I must say, I think today was my finest hour. Why I said that, people? Because today I really stood up for myself. And I spoke. And I crossed all my T's and dot my I's. And I basically proved my case. Now, the judge took it under advisement. Now, people, there's law. And there's justice. If this judge go by justice, I'm going to win. Even if you go by the law, I'm going to win. However, judges have a way of twisting the law. Twist it. And I have had problems with this judge before. He's a black judge just like me. But I've had problems with him before. And so I told him today that I didn't trust him. I told him I wanted to get off the case to recuse himself. But at the same time, people, I want him to be the one to decide this case. But not if he's going to do it based on bias and prejudice, because he's a government agent. He works for them. The banks are his boss, because we know the banks run America. And those of you who don't believe that, you're like idiots. I don't give a damn. You're like, if you all believe that your president and your senators and your governors and your mayors, if you really believe that they run your country, you are idiots. Because they don't run squat but their mouth to con you guys into helping them support the banks. So these judges and all these politicians, they're owned by the banks. It's a fact. So what Paul Muckle is trying to accomplish, I don't know if anyone in the court system have the guts, have the bravery or the audacity to really do what I want. And what I want is a total disordering of these banks and a practice to totally disorder them. Because banks are supposed to be controlled by people, because people don't want to put the money in the banks. First of all these too big to fail banks. The only way you could defeat these too big to fail banks like Wells Fargo, Bank of America and all these banks is to stop putting your money in them and go to the little community banks. Granted, when these community banks get big, they're going to do the same thing that these large banks are doing. But at least you all know when to dismantle them also. Anyway, I'm going off track. The point I'm trying to make, people, today I stood up for myself and I proved my case that the foreclosure was unlawful and they illegally evicted me when they arrested me and changed the locks to my door. Now, people, today is an even greater thing. Today is the 6-year anniversary, right? Today is the 6-year anniversary of when Paul Muckle started his war, his real war against Wall Street. I actually started it on in July. I filed my case July 23rd. I filed it in the state court. And I won. I'm going to show you all the news article, because the news came and did a new story on me, because I won and it was marvelous. So when I won that case, the first time I won this case was July 23rd, 2007. However, the real war started August 7th. I filed my case August 6th in the federal court, and August 7th was when the hammer fell. Now, people, first, before I show you all what Massachusetts law say and how I know I should win the case today, before I show you all that, right, let me show you all what the judge wrote back in 2007, the federal judge, the one who they said threatened to plant a water bomb in his yard. This is what they said, what he said about me in 2007. Paul L. Muckle and Irene Wood. Irene Wood is my mother. Plaintiffs versus Fremont Investment and Loan et al. meaning all the banks, okay? Memorandum and order, August 7, 2007, people 6 years ago. This has been a 6 year war. 6 year war against me and the against the Babylonians. And it's not over yet. Because even if you just want to give my house away to them, I must still fight them. So it's an ongoing war. Anyway, today it is 6 year anniversary of when the hammer dropped. And people, listen to how the hammer fell. Listen to what the federal judge said. On August 6, 2007, plaintiff Paul L. Muckle, a resident of Brockton, filed a self-prepared complaint against several financial institutions, Wall Street, and the entire home mortgage industry involved in the investing, financing, promotion, and our sale of subprime and other adjustable rate mortgages. Sick. Complaint at one caption. Listen to what the judge said, people. The complaint is essentially an indictment at the subprime and our adjustable rate mortgage industry and their conduct in regards to all of their low-income customers. Marco proposed to bring this action on behalf of all persons who have been injured by the defendant's alleged misconduct. So if the people, this federal judge, John Woodlock, called my lawsuit an indictment, and he was right, okay? He was right, it's an indictment. And today, the hammer fell on August 7th, because he took my case out. In August 7th, people, he took my case out. But you do know how I got it back? I went back to him about a week later with evidence to show him that it's an indictment, yes, but look at the crimes. So he said to me, people, listen what happened, right? People, listen what happened. This, I don't think this have ever happened in history. I mean, I shouldn't say that. But what I mean is that no regular person could do this. People, I went into the courthouse, right? In the federal courthouse. In the clerk, I said, I want to see Judge Woodlock. They said, well, you can't just come in and say one thing. Judge, you got to do a motion. I said, no, I want to see him today. They said, what for? I said, because I got some information about what these banks are doing to the people and my life could be in danger. So I need to see him. He need to see what I know. He need to know what I know. So people, they said, okay, why don't you write the judge a letter and we'll see what we could do. People, I wrote the judge a note. Tell him my life was in danger. I need to see him. People, within 1 hour, that judge, and that's what made me like him so much, that judge between 1 hour, people, that judge agreed to see me. Damn, I mean, come on. You have to make an appointment to see a judge. And you're not going to get it the same day. But people, that's why I know it was divine. Because within 1 hour, a federal judge agreed to see me. Within an hour. And people, the federal judge, when he see the evidence, he like, wow. And you know what he said, people? This court. Okay, people, this is what the judge wrote, right? On August 17, 2007, I went to see him. This is what he wrote, and I told him about what the banks were up to. This is what he wrote. Plaintiff appearing pro se. Defendant not in court. Because he just let me see him without the banks being there. It was a sneak attack. Okay? August 17th. Court informed the plaintiff that this court is not in a position to take a stance on any alleged criminal issue raised by the plaintiff. So you see, people, this judge is going to tell me, right? I present to him that the bank was committing crimes against the people. And the judge tell me the court is not in any position to take a stance on it. So that's when the war started. August 7th, when he dismissed my case at first. Because when you dismiss the case against me, that's going to make me fight even more. You see, it's the opposite. When you deny me something, I'm going to come back at you like 100,000 pounds of lead. So that's what I did. So anyway, people. Anyway. I went to court today. I'm going too fast. This is what happened, people. When I met back on the 17th, he told me to refile my complaint. Tell me what the bank's doing. I did. And I won. went back to court, people. He grew up in the case. And I won. He summons the banks into the court. He summons them. And he told them, there have been violations. I'm not going to permit you to take his home. That's what the bank, that's what the judge told them, people. I'm not going to permit you to take his home. I'm ordering you to go in there and give him a deal. Work on a deal with him so he could keep his home. That's what the judge did, people. But I stood up and I said, no, Your Honor. Any deal they give me, they have to give it to every single American, American resident who's having problems with their mortgage. You have to do that, Your Honor. If not, it's war. I told him that, people. Either you give everybody the same thing, or it's war. I'm going to fight you guys. And for four years or so, they tried everything. They tried to bribe me. They threatened me with arrest. They did everything, people. Everything they did to get me to drop this case. They offered me $120,000 just to fix my house. They offered me $100 a mortgage a month. Mortgage. They offered me shut up money. Everything. And I keep saying no. So finally, when they couldn't buy me, they arrested me. And charged me with trying to plant water bottle bombs in this judge yard. And the weasel attorney for the banks. Now, here's how I should win the case, people. The eviction case. This is how I should win the eviction case. Because, like I said, I went to court today to defend myself from being evicted. But people, under Massachusetts law, a foreclosure is invalid for a number of things. I'm going to read them to you. Okay. This is Massachusetts General Laws. Right? This is chapter 244. Foreclosure and redemption of mortgage. Okay? Section 14. The mortgagee, a person having this estate in the land mortgage, are a person authorized by the power of sale, or the attorney duly authorized by a writing under seal, or the legal guardian, a conservator of such mortgagee, or a person acting in the name of such mortgagee, or a person may upon breach of condition and without action do all the acts authorized are required by law. But no sale under such power shall be effectual to foreclose a mortgage unless, provided previous to such sale, notice thereof has been published once in each of 3 consecutive weeks, the first publication to be not less than 21 days before the day of sale in a newspaper, if any published in the town where the land lies are in a newspaper with general circulation in the town where the land lies, and notice there has been sent. People, this is the most important part. No sale under such power shall be effectual to foreclose a mortgage, right? Unless notice thereof has been sent by registered mail to the owner or owners a record of the equity of redemption as of 30 days prior to the date of sale. Said notice to be mailed at least 14 days prior to the date of sale to said owner or owners to the address sent for set forth in section 61. Of chapter 185, I'm sorry. Okay? Let's go down here. If in either case no adjust appear, then the adjust to which the tax and unless a copy of said notice of sale has been sent by registered mail, listen people, and unless a copy of said notice of sale has been sent by registered mail to all persons of record as of 30 days prior to the date of sale holding an interest in the property due to the mortgage being foreclosed. Said notice to be mailed at least 14 days prior to the date of sale to each such person at the address of person set forth in any document evidencing the interest or to the last address of such person known to the mortgagee. So you see people, under the law people, they have to, you have to, within 30 days, give me notice that you're trying to sell my house. Any person of record as of 30 days prior to the date of sale holding an interest in the property due to the mortgage being foreclosed may waive at any time, whether prior or subsequent to the date of sale, that the right to receive notice by mail to such person under section, and such waiver shall be deemed to constitute compliance with such notice requiring for all purposes. The point being, people, they never notified me within 30 days of May 2nd they're gonna sell my house. Those of you been watching me know they told me they're gonna sell my house on April 18th. Then they arrested me on April 13th. But the trick people, they were supposed to sell a house on April 17th. The 18th was a trick date. But I bailed out on April 17th, so they canceled the foreclosure. So now they plan to sell my house on May 2nd. Now think about people. From April 18th to May 2nd, that's not 30 days. Okay? That's not 30 days. That's like what? 15 days? 14, 15 days? Okay? So within 2 weeks, right? At the date I expected my house to be sold, which was supposed to be April 18th, but it wasn't April 18th, it was probably April 17th. So, I expected my house to be sold on April 18th, 2012. But April 18th was a trick date. The real date, they're going to sell my house. See the proof right here. Was April 17th. The U.S. Marshal said right here, we have received notification that Mr. Muckle's house is up for bank action on 4/17/2018. Mr. Muckle is unaware of this. So people, these people didn't even tell me my house was going to be sold. It was a few days later, on April 24th, when they sent me a notice. But they sent a notice April 24th. When will I get it, people? Actually, I did get it the 24th, I think. So, people, register mail, make sure the date that I receive it, that will be the first day. Not when they mail it, but when I receive it. 30 days notice. So, if you send it to me on March 24th, 26th, you mail it March 24th, I'm going to get March 26th. How many days are you telling me my house is being sold on April 18th? How many days is that? From March 26th to April 18th, March of 31 days, that's 5 and 18 is what? You are in trouble. 23 days. You owe me a whole week. So, the point being, they're in trouble, people. And if this judge rule against me, then he must be crazy for real, because the law is the law. You can't get around it. You have to give me notice 30 days before you take my property. You gotta tell me you're gonna take it from me. So people, The hammer fell today again. But today I dropped it. And the war goes on another 6 years. Because I'm not going to stop until one of you guys go to jail. I will not stop until some of these banksters are in prison. Okay? Or maybe someone kill you all. Is that a threat? I didn't say me. I said someone. Because someone need to do it. You all are evil. These banksters are evil. I'm so pro-life. But I shall not weep if these banksters get popped. Because y'all are popping people's life. Y'all are destroying people's life. Someone need to take a stand. It's not gonna be me, so don't come looking for me. Go looking for my God. Because he's going to take a stance against you all. Go look for him. Go look for the son. And arrest the son. Okay? My Lord is my weapon. My Lord is my killer. Okay? Someone need to take a stand against your banksters. Paul Muckle, I've done everything possible. But pick up arms against you all. And you are not going to bring me to that point. But someone will. Other people will bring it to you guys. And I shall not weep for you all. Because you are like evil. So anyway, people. My 60th anniversary of fighting in the federal court for everybody. The 60th anniversary for me fighting for myself was on, what is it, July 23rd, when I won the case the first time in the state court. Then when I won in the state court, I said, let me take it to the federal court to help everybody now. So, and this is the news that started it all. This one was July 23rd, but like I said, my real war started August 7th. When the judge denied me and said it was an indictment, and that just lit my fire. By him having the audacity to deny me and tell me I cannot defend any people, it's like you're telling me I can't walk, I talk, I could do anything I damn well please. No, you could tell me I can't do it, but it don't mean I'm ain't gonna try and do it. Because I'm just like any one of you. I'm just as powerful as any of you judges, any of you president, any of you lawyers, I'm equal to you. You're not superior to me. Just because you have a college degree, it don't mean you're superior to me. Just because you have a power, you're not superior to me. Who the hell gave you that power? We're the people. We give you that power because we could take it at any moment we want to take it. But we are so afraid. So you guys have no power. None. We got the power. And we're such freaking fools. And we go on and we talk and we complain and we say this and that. Then the next day we're in the election booth voting for you all, rascal. I'm talking about the politicians and some judges too. We complain. We complain. And then we go every year, we go and do the same freaking thing and vote for you guys. We complain. But when somebody do something to one of you guys, who do we rally around? If anybody do something to any of the politicians, who do we rally around? The politicians. The bloodsuckers. We rally around them. But they're the one hurting us. People, it's time to abandon these people. Don't abandon your homes. Don't abandon your planet. Don't abandon your country. Abandon your leaders. Abandon your tormentors. Those are who you should abandon. Don't abandon your moral and your ethics. Don't abandon your love for your people and your country. Abandon your leaders. because they are the ones who have you in chains. Now, I've said enough for one night. I'm tired. I've been up for since freaking Thursday night working on this defense, working on filing an appeal brief and fighting this weasel off at the same time. So I am so exhausted. People shouldn't be able to speak to you guys. I should be dropped. That's how exhausted, both physically and mentally. But my mind can go more, but my body can't take anymore right now. I've been up for so many hours. Wow, I can't even sleep. I've been trying to sleep since I came on court and I can't even do that. How my body's so tense. But I feel fine. I just feel so energetic. But I know I'm tired, but my mind is so energetic, but my body don't want to take no more. My body wants some rest. I'm going to take some rest right now. Because today was a war. I mean, it was a real war. And I feel I won. I know I won. But will they give me the win? Who knows? So anyway, here's the news that they did on me a few years ago. You know, I hope you guys, those of you who are losing anything, I hope you just take heart by it. You know, stand up for yourself. I mean, it's like cancer. They tell you, oh, you get cancer. But if you don't take a surgery, if you do surgery, you might die. But if you don't do surgery, you might die anyway. So what are you going to do? Don't take the surgery? You might as well go through it. Like pulling teeth. You know it hurts, but you got to do it anyway if you want relief. So that's how I see it, you know. You got to go through the grind then. In order for you to reach the other end, in order for you to cross the river, you're going to get your ass wet. Unless you're going to fly over there, take a boat over there. But isn't that the easy way out? I don't like the easy way out, people, because I get no satisfaction out of that. So anyway, here's the video. I talk enough. Blessed to all of you who send me your support. I love you guys. You know, I fight for you guys too. So, you know, you all are my heart and my strength. Much love to you guys, you know. So, you know, see the colors of love, unity. You know, I'm tired, so let me shut up and show you all the video, okay? One love. I love you guys.
Led to the threats of foreclosure.
But by acting as own lawyer, the homeowner convinced a judge that taking away his home would tear his family apart. Here's News Center 5's Amalia Beretta.
You want to grow up in this house?
Paul Muckle says his two small sons are two big reasons why he fought to keep the house he bought a year ago, a major fixer-upper.
Nothing was before the 1950s. It was
Muckle is a finished carpenter who is completely remembering his house himself. This spring, he says he suffered neck and back injuries in a car accident that kept him from working. He also fell behind in his house payments. He says his lender, the American Servicing Company, threatened foreclosure unless he agreed to a new, much higher mortgage payment.
My payments went from $2,064 to $3,800 per month.
Unable to pay, Muckle went to those calling for mortgage industry reform. But he says the governor's office and the attorney general's office turned him away.
It's like Chicken Little crying, the sky is falling, but no one is doing nothing to keep the sky from falling.
So Muckle went here to the Brockton Superior Court. Acting as his own lawyer, he was granted an emergency hearing to stop the foreclosure. He argued to Judge Jeffrey Locke that foreclosure is unethical because it is an assault on the American family.
A home is like you have a life of its own. And when you take that from somebody, you're killing their spirit. You know, you're killing them. When you take away home, you destroy communities. You destroy families.
Judge Locke ordered a stop to the auction of Muckle's home scheduled for tomorrow. The parties are due back in court in 2 weeks with a new affordable plan for Muckle. Attorneys for the lender did not return a phone call.
The message Paul Muckle says he wants to send to others facing a similar situation is don't give up. He says if he would have given up, he would definitely have lost his home. In Brockton, Amalia Barreda, News Center 5.